In the last class, we've looked at the concept of unit cell, right? And if you are having a lattice, you can, in principle, identify infinite number of unit cells, possible unit cells that can actually fill the entire space. But then the question is, what should be the geometry, right? What should be the geometry of that unit cell? Should it always be a parallelogram, or should, can it be, for instance, in 2D, should it always be a parallelogram? Can we not have a triangular unit cell? And so on, right? So, the way that the unit cell is defined is the following. So, unit cell is an entity which, when translated along the lattice vector or along the coordinate direction. So, for instance, if you are talking about 2D, what are the parameters that are required to describe a unit cell? For instance, one vector in x direction, and another vector in y direction. So, this is vector, let us say A, the distance is A and the distance is B, and the angle alpha, right? Now you can have, so this side is A, that side is B, and they are at an angle, A and B have an included angle of alpha. So, now you can define as many number of unit cells as you want. So, you can have conditions like A equal to B and alpha equal to 90 degrees. Then you will have a square unit cell. If A is not equal to B and alpha equal to 90, then you will have a rectangular unit cell, and so on, right? So, when you have this small geometry, and if you take this geometry and translate the geometry in the lattice directions, lattice vector directions, this is what is called lattice vector. And you take this geometry and translate it both in x direction as well as in y direction for 2D, then it should fill the entire space. It should not leave behind any voids. Only then such a geometry qualifies as unit cell. So, now imagine having a triangle, right? Can you fill the entire space of this particular lattice using a triangular unit cell of your choice without leaving behind any voids? Is it possible or not? Just by translation, it is not possible. You will have to rotate the unit cell, and hence your triangle cannot be a qualified unit cell for filling the space, right? So in general, in 2D, a parallelogram will be a qualified unit cell. And in 3D, a parallel pipe will be a qualified unit cell, right? And what will be a unit cell in 1D? It will be a line. Line will be the unit cell in 1D. And then we have discussed the concept of primitive unit cell and non-primitive unit cell, right? What is the concept of, what is the meaning of primitive unit cell? Primitive unit cell is the one which has effectively one lattice point associated with the unit cell, and if it is a crystal, then effectively it will have one atom or one molecule or one ion, depending upon what is the point that is sitting. We will talk about it in a moment, okay? So, here we have, this is the smallest unit cell, right, with highest symmetry. So, usually you choose, the guideline is you choose the smallest possible unit cell as your unit cell of the lattice that you are looking at. But it is not a requirement. You can actually, in principle, you can choose infinite number of unit cells as we have shown, and then fill the space. Okay? Alright. So, again, previously we have seen a rectangular unit cell, and hence you have a different set of unit cells that you would get. Here, it is not possible to get square as a unit cell, because the way the lattice points are arranged, it is not possible to get square as a units. And so you will find something else as your appropriate units. Okay. And here you have seen this is a primitive unit cell, this is a non-primitive unit cell, right? Why is it a non-primitive unit cell? Because effectively it has two lattice points per unit cell, and hence it is a non-primitive unit cell. So you can also choose non-primitive unit cells to fill the space. There is no problem with that. All right. So this, I think we have looked at this concept. So you have this styling, and then a two-dimensional map, and you are trying to see different kinds of what are the different unit cells that are possible. So we have already identified this as a one possible unit cell, and then that geometry as another possible unit cell, and that geometry as another possible. All right. So now we have only looked at the definition of lattice, right? What do you mean by crystal? What is the difference between crystal and a lattice? So lattice, by definition, is a translationally periodic arrangement of points in 3D. That's what we have seen, right? When we saw the Cambridge wall example, what we did was we have identified bricks that look identical, right? And then it's a two-dimensional space, and we have identified those points and then removed the brick wall. And then the set of points is what we call lattice. So it's basically a translationally periodic arrangement of points in 3D in general, but if you are defining a 2D lattice, that will be in 2D. If you are defining 1D, then it will be 1. Clear? Now, what is crystal? So, we only said lattice, when we are defining lattice, we only said points, right? Periodic arrangement of points. These points can actually be occupied by some real stuff. If they are occupied by atoms, ions or molecules, then that becomes a crystal, right? So a translationally periodic arrangement of atoms is what is called, in 3D is what is called a crystal. Sometimes a crystal need not be of a pure metal, but it can be of an alloy. So that means instead of having, if you look at iron crystal, so only iron will be there, but if you want to look at iron oxide, Fe2O3 will be there at the lattice. That is the, so, to reinforce this idea of the correspondence between lattice and crystal, a crystal is nothing but lattice plus a motif or basis. That means whatever sits on the lattice point is what is called motif. Then the moment you add motif, then that becomes a crystal of that motif, right? So, what lattice tells you is how to repeat the points, right? So the moment you remove, we have removed the brick wall, you have got the points. Now, once you have the points, you can actually construct the entire brick wall, because it told you and it showed you how to repeat these points. So lattice tells us how to repeat. And what does basis or motif tells us is what to repeat. So in 2D, we have seen how many lattice parameters are required in two-dimensional situation. To define a lattice, or to define a unit cell, to define a unit cell, 3, A, B and alpha. In 3D, you have 3 edges and 3 angles, so A, B, C, alpha, beta, gamma, right? You have the 6 lattice parameters, and then you get the cell of the lattice, right? That's the unit cell. Please note that unit cell has nothing to do with the size being unity. Okay, so unit cell size need not be 1. It is the basic unit that is being repeated, right? It is not about the number 1, it is the basic unit that is repeated, that is why it is called unit cell. Okay, and then that cell of the lattice, you have this cell of the lattice, and then from there you can actually construct the lattice. But that will not be called a crystal. The lattice cannot be called a crystal. You can only call lattice as crystal when you add a motif to that, okay? So how do we understand that? So let us say these are your set of points, lattice points. Okay, and then you have your heart as motive. Okay, and you put heart at each and every position, and then you get something called love crystal or heart. You replace that with football, then you will get football crystal. You replace that with hatred, you will get hatred. You can construct any crystal, right? So that is the idea. So now you replace that, and then you know what clearly the difference between how do you distinguish the definition of a lattice and a crystal, right? All right. So in summary, in 2D, any parallelogram whose vertices are lattice points in a unit cell, in 2D you will have any parallelogram whose vertices are lattice points. If it is 3D, it should be a parallelopipe. And we have discussed that in principle you can have infinite possibilities for unit cells in 2D and 3D. How many possibilities are there in 1D? How many different kinds of unit cells can you generate in 1D? Infinity? How? Very good. How many primitive lattice, the primitive unit cells can you define in 1D? How many? In 2D? Okay, think about it. Okay?